Remembrance Day, and he wants, again, he appreciates the fact that everybody does remember him, or does remember the day. Okay, what else is he saying? So, the last part of his life, he was in a, like, an assisted living or in a nursing home. He was, he is quite a quiet man because it's taken a lot of energy for him to come through. He never wanted for much in life. Like he outlived his wife. He did have a son that he outlived as well.
I can take some of this dirt.
You can take some of it?
Yeah, I can't take the mustache.
Okay. All right, I'm just gonna give more information. He was, before he went into this nursing home, he was a very independent man.
Yes.
Yeah, and he liked to sit down and have conversations with people, but he's just telling me that people are too busy. They were too busy to sit down and actually have a great conversation about, like, as I say before, about his story. So that to him, that's the regret before he passed, that people don't sit down and talk like they used to talk when he was a younger man.
Yeah, I can accept that, yeah.
Okay. All right, so I'm just gonna come to you.
Okay,
please. Okay. He said, you know, life was so busy that when he was in the assisted living facility, people didn't have time for him. There was no time. Everybody was rushed all the time, like the people who worked in there.
Mm-hmm.
They and he understands that because he said, that's what life is like now, but it's not what life was like then. So I'm just going to give you a message from him. He said, I really appreciate and thank you for the time that you take to talk to younger people and to listen to them. Okay. He said, because not everybody does. He said, people will listen, but they don't hear what other people say. You actually hear what somebody says, and then you can bring it back in the conversation. Do you understand what he's saying?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Thank you. And I'm just going to let him go in Spirit's love and light and thank him for coming. Okay. So the next person I have, this person has been around for quite a while, and I would say he's a little wiry man, and he traveled a lot, but not overseas, or I'm saying not out of the country of his origin, and he would have traveled to the next town, or gone to into a city, or into a village, and so he wore a hat. I'm not too sure what they call it. Is it a fedora? One of those little hats with a brim on it and a band on it, a black band on it. So he was, he wore his hat most of the time, and he was quite a character. He would go visiting, he liked to visit people, he was quite sociable. Anybody familiar with this gentleman? Okay, let's go back here. So I'm not seeing the gentleman from Canada, I see this gentleman from a different country. And I want to say that I want to put him in the range or on the side of father of this gentleman or grandfather. Can anybody take this gentleman? Okay.
He seems familiar to me.
Oh, no.
I know.
Sorry.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I was trying not to say
that. So was I.
Okay, all right. So I guess I will come to you, but this is kind of, I'm sorry, this is unusual for. I'm not going to you, okay? All right, okay, so you understand who he is? Your grandfather?
He's my great uncle, my grandfather's brother.
Okay, all right, okay. so he definitely was very sociable, and he liked, and I've got this theme, they've come with this theme of telling stories, right? He liked to tell stories, would you understand that?
Yeah.
Yeah, he was a great storyteller. He's telling me that he also was a stretcher. He stretched it sometimes.
I can see that.
Yeah. But he said not in an unpleasant manner, more in a funny manner, that he would stretch things. Okay. So since you know who he is, we'll just go to the message. quite chuffed that you were here and that he's able to come and connect with you, because he's connected, you understand, he's connected with you before?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So it's easy for him to come in. All right. So what is he saying? He's saying, he's saying, please don't take things to heart so much. He said, you know, sometimes you wear your heart on your shoulder. He said, I want you to wear, when you put your heart on your shoulder, put it back where it belongs, okay? Yeah, and don't let things bother you so much, because things bother you and you internalize them and then you get quite stressed out about them. So we said, I just want you to blow it off, put that heart back where it belongs, okay?
Okay,
can I leave that with
yep,
you?
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, all right. So I'm sorry, I have a cold here. Two very, very quiet people here. I actually have a husband and wife, so this would be grandparents here. And the husband treated, he was quite tall. He was thin and tall, and she was little and short. And he showed me that he opened doors for her all the time. He would open the vehicle door for her. He treated her like gold, and he said, that's what's lost in this era, this time, is that, you know, we don't treat the people that we love in this the manner and the fashion that we used to as gentlemen years ago. So this gentleman would have been in the forces as well. And I also want to say that this gentleman, this couple, I don't see them originating from Canada, but I see them possibly moving to Canada. Okay, what else is he going to tell me? He's saying that she didn't drive, but the fact that she didn't drive, it was okay because he loved to do everything for her. So could anybody take this, these grandparents? Okay. All right. Okay, they didn't so much as walk around everywhere as that they drove around, because I see him constantly opening the car door for her and getting her in. And I want to say that she passed before he did, because he also looked after her when she was ill. Okay. Anybody take this? Okay. I want to say when he, after he got out of the service, he was, he worked in, like, with paper, with an accountant or insurance company. He used his brain rather than his brawn to work. He was very, very, a very smart man. Nobody can take this person.
Maybe take him.
Okay, all right. And he would have been your
uncle?
Okay, all right. If he set his mind to something, he would actually go through with it. Would you understand that?
Yeah,
okay. And he was very much a gentleman as well. Okay. And he said, that's evidenced by how I treated my family. Okay. Right. What's his name?
Nelson.
Okay. He's telling me, he said, I even have a diplomatic name. All right. So I'm just going to come with a message for you, okay, from him. So he said that, you know, he started life from nothing and he worked his way up. Like he said he strived for things to happen in his life. And he said, if we have hope, things happen. If we don't have hope, if we lose hope, then things don't happen in our life. So he said, I want you to keep hope for things, for good things to happen in your life, okay? And look forward and look to us to help as well. And we'll help from the divine source as well. He said, you just have to ask. So I'm just going to leave that with you, okay? Right. So thank you, everybody.